In today's video, I am going to explain why muscles around occiput and upper cervical spines are important. I will explain muscles from superficial layer to deep layer. Let's get started. First thing first, when muscles around this area get tight, that can create headache, neck pain, and tightness. Tightness around neck and head. This is very important area. First muscle is this one, this very big muscle. This is trapezius. Trapezius, that attaches to occiput, of course. And it attaches to ligament around cervical spines. And this continuation goes all the way down to thoracic spine 12. That is the most inferior part of thoracic spine. Ah, that's so important. When this muscle gets tight, that pulls head this way. Then this can create tightness that can be caused for headache and neck pain. Very important. The next one on superficial layer is this one. It's slightly hard to see from posterior view. This is sternocleidomastoid mastoid. Sternocleidomastoid mastoid. Why is this muscle name so long? Because that represents attachment. Sternocleid. That means this muscle attaches to sternum and clavicle, sternocleid, and mastoid. Where is mastoid? This bony tip on lateral part of head. This is mastoid process. Then, if you go a little bit more detail about sternocleid mastoid, this muscle also attaches to occiput. Yep, this is important to know. So it's like trapezius. When sternocleid mastoid contracts, gets tight, that pulls head inferiorly, then that creates tightness around here, then that can lead to headache and neck pain. Plus, trapezius and sternocleid mastoid can be one reason for headache, but let me talk about this thing later. Then let's go to middle layer. Trapezius and sternocleid mastoid are removed. I will explain two muscles in this picture. This is splenius capitis. Splenius capitis. This muscle also attaches to occiput. And some anatomy books say this attaches to mastoid process. Again, mastoid process. What kind of muscle attaches to this place? That is sternocleid mastoid. So this area, posterior part of head and the lateral part is so important for muscle attachment. Do you see that? Then deep to splenius capitis, there's muscle like this. This is semispinalis capitis. Semispinalis capitis. See, this muscle attaches to occiput. By the way, when muscle layer goes deeper and deeper, attachment to occiput goes a little bit inferior. Let's compare with trapezius. Trapezius and sternocleid mastoid is about here. How about next layer? See that? It's slightly inferior. Trapezius, middle layer, trapezius, middle layer. So it's like a peeling layer. Trapezius is most superficial. Semispinalis capitis, splenius capitis, it's slightly inferior because this is middle layer. Does it make sense? Again, these muscles can pull head this way, that may cause for headache and neck pain. Very important. This is middle layer. Let's go to the deepest layer. Okay, this is deepest layer. I'm gonna focus on one muscle group. There are four muscles. One, two, three, four. This muscle group is called suboccipital. Suboccipital or suboccipital muscle, that means same thing. This is the deepest layer among neck muscles. See, there are other deep muscles like suboccipital muscles. Why do I focus on suboccipitals today? Because this muscle is so important for proprioception. What is proprioception? If I say simply, proprioception means balance sensor. That is important for balance. If you close eyes and you bend neck, either sideways or anterior or posterior, you know where your head is, even though your eyes are closed. That is because your proprioception knows where you are. So, this is balance sensor. If this part gets aggravated, your balance sensor is not very sensitive. What's gonna happen then? Then, that can lead to headache and neck pain. You know, proprioception, balance sensor is so important. Plus, few of these muscles connect to inside part of neck, inside part of vertebra. That means there is indirect connection from suboccipital muscles to inside neck. That means for spinal cord. I don't say these muscles attach to spinal cord. There is indirect connection. Let's say this muscle. This is rectus capitis posterior minor. Rectus capitis posterior minor. That attaches to one connective tissue. Then that connective tissue has relationship with membrane around spinal cord. See? Rectus capitis posterior minor to inside part of cervical spine. This is very important. So when this part gets tight, that can be cause for head and neck pain because of this connection. Anyway, this is suboccipital. Why is this so important? Because the balance sensor is rich, okay? Then there's indirect connection to inside part of cervical spines. Most superficial layer, trapezius and sternocleid mastoid. Next layer, splenius capitis and semispinalis capitis. Of course, there are other muscles like this one. Then deepest layer is suboccipital muscles. Now let me go back to most superficial layer and let me talk about relationship between trapezius and sternocleid mastoid. When this part gets tight, that can be one cause for headache. Why is that? You see this kind of stringy kind of structure? This is nerve. This is greater occipital nerve. Greater occipital nerve. This nerve emerges from cervical spine and it shows up here and it goes all the way up to parietal area. Parietal means top of the head. Okay? When this nerve gets aggravated, that can be cause for headache around occiput and parietal area. But how come? One reason is because of trapezius and sternocleid mastoid. Trapezius. Sternocleid mastoid. Do you see there's space between these two muscles? Right here. Right here. This space is originally narrow. But what happens if this space gets narrower because of tightness of these muscles? Distance of this space gets narrower and narrower. What's going to happen then? There can be impingement. Impingement of nervous tissue can create headache and numbness. Ah, that's so important. That is why adequate tension, adequate flexibility of trapezius and sternocleid mastoid is essential. Why? Because there is nervous tissue penetrating space between these two muscles. Of course, greater occipital nerve also penetrates other muscles such as maybe semispinalis capitis, which I just explained previously. Maybe tightness of this muscle also can create tightness for greater occipital nerve. But trapezius, and some great mustard get easily tight because of too much use of smartphone, tablet, computer, writing a lot. Then that kind of head forward position makes tightness for sternum great mastoid and trapezius. Oh, that's why we tend to have headache around here. Let me repeat again. This can be one cause for headache. Of course, there are various reasons. Maybe other muscles get tight, but this is also very frequent place to create headache and neck pain. In today's video, I explained why occiput area and upper cervical area are important. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.